Hi there. So we were discussing the tuple data structure in Python. So let's see some of these functions which are present in tuple. Remember, there is one function called CMP, which is applicable to the tuple data structure, but is not present in Python 3. So we will just skip this for now, or we'll just put it here only in Python 2.7. So it's not present in 3. Let's see how we can use the other functions in tuple. So here I have two tuples declared which are almost completely identical to each other. If I have to perform a comparison, here I can directly do it. If tup2 is equal to tup3, then print both are else print not equal. Currently, the two tuples are almost exactly similar, so they will turn out to be equal, so both are equal. If I change even a single element of one of the tuple, the result, definitely, they both are not equal. Apart from checking if they are equal or not, you can also print max of tuple 2. Which is 12. Let's see how it works. So it's 12. Then print min of tup3, which let's say 1. So not equal, 12, 1. These are the things printed. And lastly, there is one more length function which you can try out on a tuple. So a is equal to len of tup3, print length of tup3 is comma a. So it works like this. So length of tup3 is equal to 8 because it consists of 8 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, starting from 0 to 7. So these are some of the tuple functions which are associated and which we are using here. Apart from that, you can also perform tuple slicing as shown here. So if you have a tuple like this, which consists of letters, say C, O, D, I, N, G, F, F, N, for example, so that's a tuple. So you can print or you can copy or you can do any operation on a particular piece of data out of this tuple. So print tup 1 to 4. Let's see, instead of explaining it here, what they actually do. So here, I'll add some of those things. So print, first I'll just put some separator to identify which output belongs to which one. So print tup 2 and then give an index. So here I'll give 0 to 2, square bracket, and then the bracket close. So not equal, length of tup 3, star star star, and then we'll get the output. So 3, 2. What is the length given? 0, 2. It will only print 0 and 1. So within the range 2, 0 and 1, those items are printed. You can change this range, say 1 to 6. It will print 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. These 5 elements. This is called as slicing of tuple. So 2, 4, 5, 12 and 5. Also, you can have this kind of output where you do not specify the starting character. So where you do not specify your starting character, it means it starts by default from 0. And of course, if needed, you can also have a reverse slicing like this. So let's see what it does. So I just give minus 4 here and then we'll run the module. So minus 4 will print the tuple in this fashion. So 3, 2, 4, 5. Just starting from first, it printed the 4 elements, 0, 1, 2, 3. So that's about the slicing of the tuple and the different functions which are used in tuple. One thing is to be remember here in tuple, why and where this tuple data structures are useful. Since they are immutable, iterating or doing some calculation like if or for through a tuple is faster as compared to any other data type. So there is a little bit of performance boost. apart from that, the second advantage of tuple is that if you have a data that is not going to change, something like a lookup table or a logarithmic table or anything, any particular piece of data that you might need in your coding, and you don't want to change it even by accident. So if you create a tuple, then even an accidental write is prevented from thread data, which in turn virtually creates our tuple being write protected. So that's how tuple works. There are simple coding practices, one of which is this, I'm just telling you. So create a tuple, my tuple is equal to apple, and check if the character P is present into it or not. And if that character is present, then also print how many times it appeared. So for example, in this tuple, P is appearing 2 times. So your output should be P is present, it appears 2 times. So I hope you will be easily able to solve this problem. You have to just look at all the functions which are present in tuple and whatever that we have studied so far in Python programming. That's the only thing that you need to complete this very simple assignment with respect to tuple. And I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.